In this video, we will learn about higher order functions in Dart. In Dart, we can pass function to other function as a parameter. We can even return a function from a function as the return value. The point is, in Dart, we can use functions as a first class object. For example, I will define a very simple function here. Let's say we want to create a function that will add numbers from a given list. So I can define a function, let's say I have void and then add numbers or get sum. Now to this function, I will pass two parameters. The first parameter is the list that we want to sum. So here I will write list of type int and I have the variable name as numbers. For the next parameter, I will define a function. So whenever you want to define a function that will take a function as an argument, then you have to use function class as the type. So here I will write function and I will name it result. Now if you control click on this function, then you can see the function is a class in Dart. And we will use this class to store functions if we want to store a function as an object. Now we have a function. And inside this function, we will perform a sum operation. So what we need to do is we need to read all the numbers given in this list and we need to add them. So it is pretty simple. I will define a var sum of type 0 and then I will run a loop for all the items in the list. So I will write here var I equals to 0, I is less than numbers dot length. And then I plus plus, and I will write here sum plus equals to numbers I. Now this way I will get the sum of the numbers given. Now I need to return this sum. Now usually what we do is we can change the return type to integer and we can return the sum. But this time I will not return the sum directly, but I will use this function and I will call this function and I will pass the sum as an argument to this function. So what I will write here is I will write result and then I will pass sum. Because this result is a function and that is why I can call it as we call any other function. Now let's use this void getSum that we created. Now inside my main function, I will define a list of numbers. So let's say I have a var nums equals to, let's say I have 2, 2, 4 and 4. So this is my list and I want to get the sum and I will get the sum using this getSum function. So what I will do is I will call this function. So let's write getSum. And as the first parameter, I can pass this nums. But what about the second parameter? Because this parameter is a function, we need to create a function first. And you can create a function and you can store it inside a var. Or you can create a function f1 or any name, this is just a variable name, equals to, you will create a function. Now the syntax to create a function is, we will write parenthesis. Now inside the parenthesis, you can define all the parameters that you want for your function. If you do not have any parameter, you can leave the parenthesis blank. But in this case, I want to pass sum. And that is why I will define a parameter that is int sum. If you have more parameters, you can use comma and define as many parameters as required. But in this case, I want only one. So you will write a parenthesis and you will define all the parameters. After this, you will write an arrow operator that is equals to and greater than. And here you will write your function definition. In this case, I want to just print the sum. So here I will write print sum. And that's it. We have a function that we have stored in this f1 instance that is of type function. You can also use var here. Because in Dart, it is not necessary to write the type of the variable. So you can write either function or var here. Let's leave it with function for now. So we have a function f1 that takes an integer as a parameter and then it prints the integer. Now we can pass this f1 as the next parameter to this getSum function. So what I will do is I will write f1 here like this. Now if I run the code, I should get 4 plus 4 that is 8 plus 2 10 and plus 2 12 because it is printing the sum. So let's run the code to see what we are getting, and you can see we are getting 12. So what is happening here is we are calling the getSum function and we are passing this list of numbers and we are passing this function f1. Now here we are calculating the sum of the numbers and we are calling the function that we passed as an argument to this getSum function. And we are passing the sum that we calculated. So here we are getting the sum that is calculated here and we are printing the sum here. Now if you have only one statement for your function, you can write it like this. As I did here, I used this arrow operator and I have written print and then sum. But if you have multiple statements inside your function, you can remove this arrow operator and you can use curly braces. And now you can write as many statements or expressions as required. So here we can print, or I will print at the top, sum is and then sum. And if I run the code now, I will get sum is and then 12. Now if you want to write multiple expressions inside your function, you have to use it like this. But if it is only one expression, you can use arrow operator and then you do not need to write curly braces, same as we did in the initial function video. And you can also use named argument, optional argument and other stuffs here while defining the function that we already learned in the last video. Now here I have written 3 points. So let's understand one by one. In Dart, we can store function as a first class object that we did here. We created a function object and we stored our function. Then we have anonymous functions or lambda. So here you can see the function that we created do not have any name. And this kind of function is called anonymous function in Dart. And this is also called lambda. So this is the lambda that we created here. And lastly, we have higher order functions. So any function that either accepts a function as a parameter or returns a function as a return value, or it is doing both the things, that is accepting a function as a parameter and returning a function as the return value, then this kind of function is called higher order function. Now let's create one more function that will return a function as the return value. And it is very easy. Whenever you want to return a function, what you can do is you can define the return type as function. And then you can write any function name, let's say my func, and this function will return a function as the return value. So here I will write return, and then the same way we will define a function that we want to return. So we will write parenthesis, and if you have only one expression, you can use this and write the expression. Let's say my function is called. Or if you have multiple expressions, then you can delete this thing and you can write as many expressions as required. And at the end, you need to write semicolon like this. So right now I have only one print statement, so I will use it like this. Now, whenever I will call my function, so I will call my function like this. Now, what I am getting here is another function and I can call it like this. And if I run the code now, you can see I am getting the output. So basically this function is returning another function that we are calling here. So this is how you can define higher order functions or lambdas in your Dart program. So that is all for this video, friends. Thanks for watching.